Welcome to episode 59 of Liquid Velvet Literature here on Prose Radio. Our intro music, courtesy Grace Jones, track La Vie en Rose from the 1977 album Portfolio. I'm your guest host, Mavia, and today's requests are all for the new blood recently coming in to theprose.com. And we're so delighted to welcome everyone. Let's begin with Clive Dalton with a piece called Slip Fasting. Shapeshift and slip fast. 1. Wander freely between now and past. Scribe the sighs and laments, fast talk and curses, and the coins of silver slipped into purses. Memorize the melodies of the street sounds and churches, and the creel and haul of the wet fish markets. Slink all four paws on painted claws, tipped red rouge and gorgeous, home to the sleep curl and deep dive, purring out songs of the neverlast. And then Clive Dalton has a footnote 1 with a definition, slip fast, adjective, longing to disappear completely, to melt into a crowd and become invisible, so you can take in the world without having to take part in it, free to wander through conversations without ever leaving footprints, free to dive deep into things without worrying about making a splash. And this is actually a quote we see here cited from The Dictionary of Obscure Sorrows by John Koenig. Thank you so much for that. What an interesting piece. Really, really beautiful use of the language and creative word making. And our next writer is Superglue77 with a piece of micropoetry in a challenge featured on the Spotlight page. The challenge is from our friend Last. Shout out to Last, who is not feeling so well right now. We all are wishing you well and hoping you're going to feel better soon. The challenge is H2O, a micropoem about water, form of your choice. And Superglue77 writes, philosophical water. The forms of water are limitless. It's universal and dissolves all barriers. So basic, it was thought to be an element. Yet so complex, it is the measure of man. From Thales to Reichardt, water bonds us together and differentiates us from dirt. Beautiful piece, Superglue77, and I also wanted to read another one because our friend Superglue77 had recently won a challenge. The biggest hole in my life was left by whom or by what, poetry or prose, by our consistent friend and long-term proser, Ditejon. And that piece from Superglue77, A Void Dance. Fill the void so I do not feel what is wrong or what is real. Dancing around the endless gap, my feet grow tired, my mind is trapped. A hole's a hole, but to what extent? Why had I been so distant? Should I want or need or care? My hole's a burden, why don't I share? I cannot be my best self here. I've been dancing led by fear, staying, clasping, trying to hold on. I could let go, but then I'd move on. There is a place I want to go, but I'd leave here with nothing to show. Departing here is my biggest void. Arriving there, I'll be employed. My job's a burden, but I should see. This job is just not right for me. Many people in the world in that situation, Superglue77, it is so important to have meaningful work and sustainable occupation. Thank you for that. And this one, a first post from our friend Emlov, entitled Memories. Where does your mind go when it wanders free? What are those memories when you think of me? Good, bad, or does it even remember me? Does your memories show up fragmented? Or is there one that lives rent-free? Do you ever force up memories? Or is that only me? Do you still hold on to memories that you promised just to keep? Have you ever had those memories that tend to touch you deep. Do you have those type of memories? If you close your eyes, you'll see. Do you ever have those memories? You pray that they just leave. Do you feel shame from some memories? For me, those ones cut deep. Looking forward to seeing more pieces from Emlov. And our last piece is from new friend Ruby Drake with a piece titled Egg. Still and quiet. What a joy it is to know nothing about my own nothingness. Shelled in my own elaborate cave, hermetically sealed in a liquid paradise. I revel in the nest of my own invention, or at least that is what I think it is. But you'll forgive my solipsism, for you have had it too, wrapped up in bed at night, when all the tired slaves make their way home at last to set an alarm, to start a new day for a spectacular routine of disappointments and mundane miracles. But I've always had it here, inside my fragile casing, as pockmarked as the moon, yet smooth and luminous at a distance. I wonder, will I see the light of day? And I wonder, do I want to? Break me, roll me over, and crack me with a spoon? No. I'll hold still and quiet and not say a word. Silence is my armor, a shield to wrap myself inside. And I bide my time for this journey I am going to take. Listen. There is a clock ticking, or is it sand trickling through an hourglass? Is this the sound that makes the silence before the sound? From top to bottom, through a slender neck, this is where I am, in between time when it is counted, just to make sure nothing happens twice, or happens once, again and again. I am a yolk, a joke, but I am not egging you on. You wouldn't believe what a song I have been singing, and the music of the spheres that I have at my command makes me weep as if I heard Bach for the first time. The dumb sense of infinity ringing in my ears that will create an ever-expanding universe. That is my ambition, and nothing will hold me back from all the galaxies rushing away from each other, trying to be free from me. The singularity, the ineffable egg that I am, the same egg that is you, rolling towards the edge. The sun creeps up the sky. Stars retreat to their slumbered beds and forget to ask why. The midnight candle flickers and burns down to the wick. The insect clock weaves a web. The spider makes it tick. The earth makes its final turn and pillows its own head to listen to the songs of dawn, no longer filled with dread. I hold my breath. But how can this be? I have no tongue to say these things, nor eyes that can even see. But a serpent is coiling around my shell, waiting to happen, happy to wait. Sit and quiet while the roar of the universe rages on. Thank you so much for that intense piece and jolt of creativity, Ruby Drake. And thank you to all our new friends and old friends at theprose.com. If you love to read, to write, be inspired, come join us. We look forward to featuring your work soon. Thank you and take good care.